Okay, so this is the new locomotive, which is radio controlled on DC. So you'll hear the clicks from the remote as I press it, as we get a light on the front and then we switch the diesel engine on. And it has various horns on it. You hear the clicks. You can turn the light off and on. And the light will come on coming forwards and backwards anyway. And let's see if I can put it in reverse. See it's going into gear. And then you start to just go. It can go quite slowly. Just trying to refocus that. The phone's not so good for focusing. Change direction. It does crawl pretty well. This is all DC. Just reverse it. Yeah, pretty good fun. I'm gonna try and tempt to film it further away now, but it's gonna be tricky. This is my test track, by the way. I'll show it going at least the circuit. A bit more speed. It runs pretty smoothly. As it comes round, I'll slow it. Now, I'll just show you the controller. There you go. Slow it down. Horn. And I've got the light and the engine sounds. It just goes without the engines. Slowing down, speeding up. And changing direction. And I can do like an emergency stop. So, the amazing thing is, this is DCC 2. Slow it a little. Not sure how slow I can get it before it stops. Yeah, pretty slow. It's a pretty nice crawl. But it stops. The only sad thing about it is that there's the engines in the cab, as you can see. But I thought about actually taking that roof off and just perhaps growing the windows a bit. I have taken the couplings out, by the way, because they're the knuckle, and I've got some adapters to put some others in. I'm not sure which one to put in yet, whether to go for the normal Hornby type or some magnetic. I still have. But yeah, I like it. I'm going to change the automatic, puts the light on when you go to the forwards position. it again. The way it works is you sync the remote with the locomotive, and then you put the controller onto half speed, and then everything's controlled with this remote control instead of through your normal controller, your analog controller, which is quite good really if you're for example using it as an exhibition, because you can walk about with it and still be controlling one of the locos and be free of the controller. I'm going to speed that up a bit now to show you it the speed. The engine sounds accelerate appropriately. A bit more speed. But yeah, pretty nifty little engine. It's a 5-pole motor. Blow it and it's got emergency stop. There you go. They do civilian versions as well, of course, but I wanted the military. It's fun. I'm just showing you now slow movement with the DCC controller. You can see the remote's not being used. And, one-handed, I'll try and speed it up a little bit. It's quite smooth. Down to speed of 1.